Screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, see, we started this chapter of function of more than one variable. So, we have discussed its limits. First, we discussed domain and range. Then, we discussed limits, continuity, okay, and then differentiability. So, do you remember if you think about your function of one variable, what will be the next thing you will discuss according to the function of one variable thing?
Continuity.
Continuity we have already discussed, no? What after differentiability? What do you discuss there in, I think it's in plus one or plus two, the differentiable, differentiability?
Surplus.
Plus, okay. After differentiability, when you learn about derivatives, you go for the application of derivatives. Do you remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
The most important thing in that is maxima and minima.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the same thing we are going to do here. Like here it was maxima and minima. So the next topic is maxima and minima of function of two variables. Okay, so before that, I would like to tell you that what are the exercises which you are supposed to do. 12.1, nothing you will do from the exercise. I have introduced little bit. You can just look for the notes. And then you have 12.2, 12.3. And then you have 12.5. 12.4 is not in your syllabus. And then you have 12.7. Is that okay? So till 12.7, we are done. This much is the part till 12.7. And this exercise is 12.8. So we are going to start with 12.8. I have already shared the problems with you people. Is that okay, students?
Yes, ma'am.
So let us start with finding the maxima and minima of functions of more than one variable. Okay. So Gagan, recording is on. Can you please check?
Yes, ma'am, recording is on.
Okay. So you already know what do we mean by minima and maxima. So, but for completeness, I'll just give you the definition once more. Suppose, let me give a definition for a function of one variable. If you have a function of one variable, so it is easy to plot the graph. This is your x-axis, suppose, and this is your axis on which you are plotting the value of, which is representing the value of the function. Suppose
excuse me, ma'am. Yes, Peter. Ma'am, we are starting with maxima and minima now?
Yes, Peter.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Exercise 12.8. So if the graph of the function is something like this, suppose your domain is A to B, right? So very easily you can see that here, this point, this point, this point, this, 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 and this, right? These points are called local minimas, okay? All these points are called local minimas. Local minimas means around these points, you can find out at least one neighborhood such that the value of the function at this particular point is the least in that neighborhood. Definition is clear to everybody. These are called local minimas. Local minimas in the sense that the value of the function, for sure, around that point, you will get a neighborhood in which the value of the function is least at the point. That point is called the local minima. And then these points here, these points are local maximas. These points are called local maximas. Again, the same definition. Local maxima means you have a neighborhood around the point such that the value at your point is maximum in that neighborhood. Is that thing clear? And these are the points, and we can observe that at these points, local maxima as well as local minima, f dash x is zero. Okay? And also, this can happen at the boundary. Boundary also can be a point of maxima minima. Let us not discuss that first. First, let me just concentrate on the interior points. Okay. And what is a global minima or maxima? Global maxima means a point which is having the highest value if you compare it as at a global level, that is in whole of the domain A to B. So here you can see that this point here, this is your global maxima. And this point here, which is having the least value in total domain, that is your global minima. Is that okay? So these are like, if you're talking about local means, you are at local level. For example, we have chief ministers of each state. They are ministers at local level. And then we have a prime minister. Okay, that is at the global level. But the concept is not exactly same, because here the global maxima is out of the local maximas only. But there we don't have that thing, right? And here global minima will be out of the local minimas. Is the definition of local minima and local maxima clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Global maxima, global minima, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Okay. So let us summarize. Given a function, fx, I'm giving you an example of 1D, like function of one variable, because it is easy for you people to understand. Then we will go to function of two variables. Given a function f of x on the interval AB, possible points of local maxima or minima are, can you tell? First is those points where f of x is 0. Second is interior. Interior means we are talking about the inside the domain, excluding the boundary. Boundary is A and B. So maxima minima can occur at those points where f of x is 0 or at the boundary, that is at x is equal to A or x is equal to B. Or can you tell me where else can a local maxima or minima occur?
Ma'am, ये आपने first point में f dash x नहीं आएगा, f dash x.
I'm sorry, f dash x, yes. Okay, so where else can the local maxima minima occur? Anybody? A point inside the boundary where f dash x does not exist. We can have a situation, for example, you can have a situation like this. This is your A, this is B. You have a function like this. Now, at this point, the function is not differentiable, because you can see at peaks, function is not differentiable. But this is the point where the global maxima is there. Is that okay? So these are the three possibilities, okay, where local minima or maxima can occur for a function of one variable. Clear? Any doubt that
no.
These are three points, three places where you have to look for the local and minima and local maxima. Now let us go to function of two variables. Suppose you have a function of two variables, fxy. So it is little bit difficult to plot, but I'll try. So your situation will be, you have xy and this is your fxy, right? So you will have a surface. So you have suppose something like this. This is your surface, okay? In Desmos or in MATLAB you can plot these things, and you can have similarly the point of local minima and local maxima. Okay, and out of those local minima and local maxima, you can find your global minima and global maxima. The concept is same. The only difference is there you had a curve, now you will have a surface, right? So if you have a function of two variables and boundary, yes, and there is a boundary, okay, so you are given a function and a domain, and there will be a boundary of the domain, right? Then possible points of local maxima and minima are, I'm not going to prove this thing, but the possible points of local minima and maxima are, number one, the points, the interior points means are inside the domain, like not on the boundary. The interior points where fx is 0 and fy is 0. Okay, so now instead of f dash x, we will have fx is 0. Fx stands for partial derivative with respect to x, and fy stands for partial derivative with respect to y. Or the interior points where either f of x or fy, fx means derivative with respect to x, and fy means derivative with respect to y, or both does not exist. Okay? Either fx does not exist or fy does not exist, or both don't exist. Okay?
Ma'am, the first point means that both the partial derivatives should be zero, no? Yes. Like it should not be either.
No, either ni and. That's why and. I have written and here. Okay, beta? So yes. Here, so the first is, you have to look for those points which are in the interior, and fx is zero and fy is zero. This is one set of points where possible minima maxima can occur. Second set of points is where either fx is not defined or fy is not defined, or both are not defined. Okay. And the third possible place to look for is the boundary.
Can okay. You second point again means?
You see, I told you, this for a function of one variable, the possible points where local and minima and maxima can occur is where f dash is zero or the f dash does not exist. Okay, so similarly here, possible points are where both the partial derivatives are zero, or one or both the partial derivative does not exist. Okay, I will give you an example. We'll do the problem, then you will understand more.
Ma'am, can you close up a bit, please?
Yeah, sure. Mute, beta. Yeah. Mute, everybody. Is that okay?
Just a moment, ma'am. Just a moment, ma'am.
Yeah, sure.
Ma'am, just a little bit, ma'am. The first part I want to just note down.
This one?
Yes, ma'am. This one. Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, so we will be informed about our mock test by today night, because tomorrow is only the mock test, right?
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, beta, I have already conveyed. Okay, you will get it on LMS information. Okay, beta? So keep checking that.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you. I'll also confirm and I'll send a message. Okay,
ma'am. Thank you.
Fine. You see, now these are the three possible places where we will look for the local minima and maxima. And these two points, where either fx is 0, fx and fy both are 0, or where one of the derivative does not exist, or both don't exist, we call these points 1 and 2, we call these points are called critical points. These points in 1 and 2 are called the critical points. Okay, so in your books, you will see that it will be written like this. Local maxima minima can occur only at critical points or boundary points. Okay? Is that thing clear? So critical points means either where fx is 0 and fy is 0, or fx, fy,
ma'am,
or both. Yes, beta.
मैम वो थर्ड पॉइंट बताने क्या लिखा है मतलब थर्ड पॉइंट में
द बाउंड्री
मैम इसका मतलब क्या मतलब द बाउंड्री
सो सपोज यू आर गिवन दैट योर फंक्शन डोमेन इज से दिस इज द डोमेन ऑफ द फंक्शन सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम इंटीरियर पॉइंट्स इनसाइड द बाउंड्री यू विल लुक फॉर द पॉइंट्स वेयर बोथ द डेरिवेटिव्स आर जीरो और वन ऑफ द डेरिवेटिव डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट एंड अदर देन दैट एवरीवेयर ऑन द बाउंड्री you can look for local minima and maxima. Okay? We will just do a problem. You will understand. Is that thing clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then let me do one problem. Then we will go to see how we can find out whether it is a point of minima or maxima. Okay, things like that. First of all, suppose this is a problem. Find the local extreme values, the local extreme values of fxy is equal to x square plus y square. Okay, now you see in this problem, no boundary is given. Can you see this function is defined for all xy and no boundary is given? So you don't have to worry about the boundary. So the only possible points, you will write like this, the possible points where local maxima and minima can occur are the critical points. Okay, as no boundary is specified. Is that thing clear to everybody? Out of the three points, no boundary is given, so boundary is omitted automatically. Now, look at this function. This is a polynomial function. Now, since f of xy is equal to x square plus y square is a function having fx and fy existing everywhere. Okay? So, the only critical points are where fx is 0 and fy is 0. So, fx is your 2x is 0 and fy is 2y is 0. So, you get x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. So, the only critical point is, therefore, the only critical point is 0, 0. Is that thing clear to everybody? For this particular function, no boundary is given. So, the possible places where you have to look for maxima and minima are the points where fx is 0 and fy is 0. So, from there you get fx, x is 0 and y is 0. So, 0, 0 is the only critical point. And because this function is differentiable everywhere, in the sense that partial derivatives exist everywhere, so you don't have to worry about that thing. Okay, so this is your answer for the critical point. Now, what is the value at the critical point? And value of the function at the critical point is 0 square plus 0 square, that is 0. Now, can you tell me, is it minima or maxima without any test? Can you just look at the function and by can you tell
minima.
Minima, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, minima. If you look at the function, your function is x square plus y square. It is always positive. Now, since fxy is equal to x square plus y square is always greater than or equal to 0, therefore, 0 is a local minima, indeed a global minima. Because other than this point, there is no other local minima. This is the only point of minima or maxima. So there is only this point which is a local minima and therefore global minima also. So now can you tell me why we did not get any point of maxima? Anybody can think?
It is going to infinity.
Increasing.
You see, there is no coming back for this particular function. How this function looks, this is like if you have, suppose this is your x, this is your y. So this is kind of bound which is increasing and never, you will never see a fall. So we will never get this thing. It is it keeps on going like this. So that is why there is no maxima, no local maxima even. Clear? Is that thing clear?
Can you repeat the point of last which we have said, bowl?
So you see, I'm saying that this is not the part of the problem, but I'm just asking you to think that why we did not get any point of maxima. So the answer to that question is, if you look at this function, this is x square plus y square. So if you have x here, y here, and this is your fxy. So if you try to plot this thing, this is a kind of bowl, right? Like this you will get. And this keeps on increasing. It will never come back. That is why you don't have this situation. So that is why you do not get any maximum point, any point of local maximum. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next is, because, okay, you have to make one, look, let me write down. Note that the above three conditions, which I have written, that where you can find out the local maxima minima, are only necessary conditions, not sufficient. It means that there is a possibility that minima and maxima can occur at these points, but you are not sure. Okay? So it means that there is a possibility that minima, maxima occurs at a critical or boundary point. But it is not sure. Clear? Surety. For surety, we will have another test. I will tell you. But right now, we have a test which is just a necessary condition. It means that there cannot be any other point where minima maxima can occur. But it is not sufficient in the sense that we are not sure that the point which we are getting from these three conditions is having for sure a minima and maxima. So I'm giving you an example. Look at this. Find the local extreme value. Find the local extreme value, if any, of fxy is equal to y square minus x square. Fine. Now you see, here again, no boundary is given. No boundary is specified. Also, fx and fy exist everywhere because you have a polynomial function, nice function. So the only possible points, the only possible points where minima and maxima can occur are where fx is 0 and fy is 0. Now what is fx? Fx is minus 2x is 0. And what is fy? That is 2y is 0. So you get x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. Therefore, 0, 0 is the only critical point. Now, we have to, here in this question, if it is asked that, what is this point? Is it the point of local minima? Is it the point of local maxima? Is it a point of local minima or local maxima or none? This is also a possibility that at this point, there is no local minima, there is nothing, neither local minima nor local maxima. Now, can you tell me, anybody? Looking at the function, can you guess, is it a point of local minima or local maxima? What is the value at 0, 0? The value of the function at 0, 0 is 0.
Zero.
Now, what is the meaning of local minima and maxima? It means that you will get at least one neighborhood in which your function is least at this point. Now you see, what is the value of the function on this axis? Value of the function on x-axis on x-axis is y is 0. Therefore, value of the function on x-axis is?
Negative.
Y square, 0 square minus x square. Negative. And what is the value on y-axis? Value of the function on y-axis?
Positive.
It means that x is 0, y-axis it is positive. So it means that if you are at 0, 0, here the value of the function is negative. Here the value of the function is positive. So it can never be a point of, it is neither a point of minima nor a point of maxima. Because you have points where value is less than 0. And you also have points where value is more than 0. So this point where the value is 0, it is neither the point of minima nor the point of maxima. So this is neither a point of minima nor a point of maxima.
Ma'am, can you please explain it again?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, sure, beta. You see, I told you that with these three conditions, whatever points you are getting, there is a chance that local minima and maxima will occur at those points, but you are not sure. Is this point clear? Whatever points yes, ma'am. We are getting from here, these are only necessary conditions. It means that if you get local minima and maximum, you will get only at these points. But it is not sure that at every point there is a local minima or local maxima. Clear? That is what I am going to explain with this example. Here I have taken this example y square minus x square. And I got this point 0, 0. This is a critical point. So now I am further checking whether it is a point of local minima or local maxima or none. Okay? Now, if you look at the definition of local minima means there is a neighborhood such that f 0, 0 is less than values at all other points in that neighborhood. Is this point clear? This is the definition of local minima I just gave you. And local maxima means 0, 0 here because I have got this point 0, 0. Otherwise, whatever point you are talking about. Local maxima means there is a neighborhood such that f of 0, 0 is greater than values at all other points in that neighborhood. Is that thing clear, students? Now, yes. If you look at this 0, 0 point, what is the neighborhood? Neighborhood means just a ball around that point. Now, in this neighborhood, what is the value of the function on x-axis? Value of the function on x-axis is y square minus x square. Y is 0, so minus x square, negative. And what is the value on y-axis? What is the value on y-axis? This is positive. Okay? Now, if you take this point 0, 0, the value here is 0. Can you claim this thing or not for this neighborhood? Tell me. Is your value less than all other values in the neighborhood? Please answer.
No, ma'am.
Because you have points where the value is negative.
That is negative, yes, ma'am.
So can you say this thing that value at 0, 0 is greater than all other values? No.
No.
Because you have positive values also. So neither this thing is true nor this thing is true. Therefore, this is neither a point of minima, local minima, nor a point of local maxima. So do you remember? In function of one variable, you used to call it as point of inflection. Here we call such points as saddle points. Okay, so saddle points are those points which are critical points, but they are not the points of minima and maxima. Clear? I'll just define it
later. What is the minimum मैम ये NBS का मतलब क्या बता देंगे?
नेबरहुड नेबरहुड NBH क्लियर बेटा नेबरहुड आई एम नॉट डिफाइनिंग इन अ मैथमेटिकल फॉर्म although neighborhood had a mathematical definition also but I'm just telling you neighborhood means you just take the literal meaning that around you okay so you just make a circle you can make a square also but we will always make a circle
ma'am
such but... types of question will not be so much for your course this is just an example so that you get an idea that this is only a necessary condition not a sufficient yes beta
But how can we neglect all other possible neighborhoods? Like for example, if my x comma y, which I'm putting in the function, they themselves lie on a parabola where the zero comma zero is
neighborhood. No, I'm not neglecting. I'm saying local minima maxima means that you should get at least one neighborhood. Here, whatever neighborhood you choose, you don't have to pick. Neighborhood cannot be like this. That this is my point. Neighborhood cannot be only these points. No. Neighborhood means you have to make a circle around your point and all the points inside that circle is your neighborhood. So neighborhood will always contain infinite points. Is that okay?
Okay.
You cannot have a neighborhood like this that I am just taking these four people. It's not like us that these three people are neighbors. Not like that. Neighborhood means you have to draw a circle around your points and inside that circle there are infinite points and all those points you have to check. Got it?
Okay. Thank you.
Yes.
ये point है 0 0 इस question के हिसाब से इसको point of inflection बोल सकते हैं?
Yes, beta. The same thing but for function of two variables we call it a saddle point. So the same point which you used to call inflection we call it as saddle point here. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, I have to go for the second derivative test. Okay. So, let us do that. So, now, let me give you a test which will tell you whether the point is a point of local maxima or local minima or none. So, you don't have to do this exercise. I just gave you an example and you can always For every question, you can draw the neighborhood and you can check. But you already saw that this is not an easy task. Okay? That we draw a neighborhood and check. So, we have a test. So, what is the test? That is called second derivative test for local extreme values. Second derivative test for local extreme values. Okay, so what is the test? We have, suppose fxy and its first and second derivatives and its first and second derivatives are continuous throughout a disk centered at a comma b where fx at a comma b is 0 and fy at a comma b is 0. So it means that suppose you got a point where both fx and fy are 0 and around that point you have a disk, a circle where the function and its first and second partial derivatives are continuous. Okay. So what is the situation? You have a point A comma B. At this point, fx is 0, fy is 0. And around that point, there is a small circle in which your function, its first derivatives and its second derivatives, they are continuous. Okay. Then f has local maxima at a comma b if fxx is negative and fxx fyy minus fxy square is positive. Okay. Second is f has local minima at a comma b if f xx is positive and this quantity fxx fyy minus fxy square is also positive. Third possibility is f has a saddle point at a comma b. Saddle point means neither the point of maxima nor of minima. So f has a saddle point at a comma b if this quantity is negative. If fxx fyy minus fxy square is negative. Okay, and the test is inconclusive. Test is inconclusive if this quantity fxx fyy minus fxy square is zero. Okay, so let me rewrite this test in another form so that you understand. So suppose on solving fx equal to 0, fy equal to 0, you get a point a comma b. Okay, at this point a comma b, what you will calculate? You will calculate fxx fyy minus fxy square. If this quantity is positive, okay, then you will further check fxx. If fxx is negative, then maxima. If fxx is positive, then minima. And if this quantity is negative, then saddle point. And if this quantity is zero, then test is not telling you anything. Then you have to apply the techniques which I have explained in the last question. Okay, so let me just give you an example so that everything is clear to you. And I will also like to tell you that this quantity to remember, you can just see that this is the determinant fxx, fyy, fxy, fxy. So you can just find this determinant fxx into fyy, fyxy minus fxy square. Okay, so let us do one problem so that you understand, then we'll stop our class. Find the local extreme values of the function fxy is equal to xy minus x square minus y square minus 2x minus 2y plus 4. Okay, so here no boundary is given, no boundary, and fx fy exist everywhere, so you don't have to worry about anything. So we'll just look for fx is equal to 0 and fy is equal to 0. Now if you put fx is equal to 0, what you will get? Fx is y minus 2x minus 2 equal to 0, and fy is x minus 2y minus 2 equal to 0. So you get from here minus 2x plus y is equal to 2, one equation. From here you get x minus 2y is equal to 2. So you can just multiply it with 2. We want to solve. You'll get 2x minus 2y minus 4y is equal to 4. And this first equation is minus 2x plus y is equal to 2. You can just add. So you'll get minus 3y is equal to 6. So your y is minus 2. And then you can compute x. So x is minus 2. So this is the only point. So the critical point is minus 2 comma minus 2. Now you have to check whether this is a point of local minima or local maxima. So for that, you will compute second derivatives. So what is fxx? fx was this. So fxx is minus 2. Okay. What is fxy? That is 1. Okay, you differentiate it with respect to y. What is fyy? This was your fy. So fyy is minus 2. So what is your fxx, fyy minus fxy square? That is minus 2 into minus 2 minus 1 square. So that is 4 minus 1, 3 positive. Okay? Mm-hmm. So no. From here, if this is positive, you see, if this is positive, then you have to check fxx. Okay? So this is positive and fxx is minus 2, which is negative. Therefore, local maxima.
Ma'am?
Sorry. Yeah, this is negative, right? So local maxima. Is that thing clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Fxx is negative, therefore local maxima. And what is the maximum value? Maximum value is, you just put it, minus 2, minus 2. You compute it, it is 8. You can check that this is 8. Okay. Is that thing clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Okay, so in the next class, we will do more problems. So don't worry if you...
Ma'am, can you scroll up a little, please?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Thank you. Ma'am, what would be there?
Yes, ma'am, a little more.
If fxy is equal to fyx...
Beta...
I'm going to scroll up a little more.
Yeah, whenever the derivatives are continuous, then always fxy is equal to fyx. Do you remember?
Thank you.
So here already I have put that condition that the derivatives are continuous.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Okay, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes.
एक बार कल जो mock test है उसका बता दो क्या कहाँ तक आना है और evaluative है कि नहीं?
No. A mock test is just for your practice, beta. That is not evaluative.